Hello friends, in this video I'll be helping with transaction security. So let's start. So an online transaction requires a consumer to disclose a sensitive information to vendor in order to make a purchase and placing himself at significant risk. So what it says is, whenever you do an online transaction, or you can say whenever you buy something from an e-commerce website, then you need to share your sensitive information like your address, your name, your phone number and other details, and also some banking details for the payment of goods and services, right? So when you do that, then you put yourself at a significant risk because your information can get leaked, right? So here comes the work of transaction security. Transaction security is concerned with providing privacy in transaction to buyers and sellers. So what transaction security does is, transaction security provides a confidentiality, or you can say secrecy, to the transaction that is happening between the buyer and the seller. So whatever information buyer is sending to the seller, then that information should be kept private, or you can say should be kept secure from intruders, or you can say from hackers. And it also protecting client server network from breakdowns and third party attacks. So what it also does is, whatever client server communication is going on, that is client communicating with the server, that should not break down. As well as if any third party attack happens, then it should prevent that particular transaction, or you can say client server communication, from any kind of third party attacks also. So let's come on to what it basically deals with. So it basically deals with client security, that is whatever data is there on the client side, that should be kept secure. Then the server security, that is whatever data is there on the server, that also needs to be secured. And whatever transaction happening between the client and the server also needs to be secured, right? And next comes is, the intruder activities may be classified into two. So whatever intrusion happens, they may be classified into two types. First is active intrusion and second is passive intrusion. So if you ask me which one is the more dangerous one, that is the passive one, because I'll be telling you. First let's discuss active one. So if you talk about active one, in active intrusion what happens is modification of information takes place, but in case of passive one, just the reading, or you can say just the listening to the information takes place. No changes to the information, or you can say no modification to the information takes place. So because no modification to the information takes place, it becomes more dangerous to detect a passive intrusion as compared to active intrusion. Okay, so I hope you got what is transaction security. If you got, then please do hit the like button, do consider subscribing, and thanks for watching.